welcome to the Green Horde. I'm the Everlast and I have two new boxes for you from Firestorm Armada. The mailman was really quick. On the 25th was the release, and today I've got the two new boxes for Firestorm Armada. The Rand System Navy gets a complete overhaul, and here are two new boxes. One cruiser box and the destroyer and frigate box are freshly arrived at my home, and let's see what's in these boxes. So let's begin with the boxes, and we start with the cruisers. The cruisers you have all already seen in the Patrol Fleet box. On the front side you see two normal cruisers and one heavy. On the back side we see the hull and the parts of the heavy cruiser. Also included flight stands. May or not. We will see. So, spot and usual, bubble wrap. I liked it. And some advertisement for Planetfall. I like space more. So we have one small pot and one bubble wrap with the ship hulls. So we have three flat packs, then three small pots. Then this must be for the normal cruiser, for the heavy cruiser, and the side parts. Let's look. Looks like the cloaking generator for the normal cruiser. Zip. And the wing parts for the heavy cruiser. So, then to the house. Three cruiser hulls. We have all molded in one part, except the side parts. One glue point here and here, and on the downside. Some flashes seen here on the front side, but nothing serious. Really nice to see the turrets on the top, very detailed. The bridge, really fine details. It reminds me on the World War I battleships, or even the World War II battleships, like the Bismarck or Prince of Wales, you name one or another. On the front side you see the four weapons, the starboard and port weaponry, beam weapons, really nice. And for the, if you play them as heavy cruisers, you have some flash, nothing serious. If you play them as heavy cruisers, you have a real nice front kinetic weapons. It blames even the Dendrenzi heavy cruiser for the same amount of points, and it's even a better ship in my opinion. So these are the cruiser box. Now go on with the new destroyers and the frigates. On the front you see the already new frigates and three destroyers. On the back side, the four Helion class frigates and the new Firebirds. So So what we've got in here, one with bigger ships, one with smaller ships, flight stands, and also the port. Also again, planful advertisement. And again, I stay in space. So let's begin with the smaller ships. So the smaller ones, come on, ladies. So really nice models. You see here on the side the weaponry. On the upper side and the lower. Here for the front weapon. And no bubbles in the front. But oh, we have. I'm lucky. I've again one with a big hole in there. I need green stuff again. I need it. The other three. Look, they are looking kind of flawless. So let's go on to the destroyers. So, oh, what's this? Do you see that? It seems they are using a dark kind of resin. Do you see the difference? And it feels more, it feels harder, not like I hope it doesn't chips. Yeah, sorry. The harder something gets, it's possible that it breaks more easy. So let's see what we have here. All we have the four weapon on the front. It is molded. The bridge, all with nice details. The wings. Some small turrets here on the side. Or is it the stealth generator? Or maybe here in the middle? We have one glue point on the other side for the flat pack. They are looking really nice. Fine models. And I think I've gotten a real fresh mold. The details are sharp as a knife. Really cool models. So let's get done. A close look at them. Fully assembled, all models look like this on flat packs for size comparison. In the front, the frigate and the destroyer. In the middle, the Shrike class cruiser, and behind, the new Hellhound. So let's get more in detail. So, as an adventure player, I'm looking forward for the frigates. They are better than, no, no, they are a good addition to my frigates and close a gap in the starboard and the port arc. It's badly needed. The cruisers are nice little beasts with the cloaks and the torpedo spook. So let's go over to the heavy cruisers. Like I said, they are
in my opinion, better than the Drenzy vessels. The same powerful kinetic foreweapon, but real broadsides, not only gun racks like the Drenzy. And they are lesser turn limits and the same speed, and damage and crit rating are equal, I think. May you correct me? You can write it down in the comments if you want to correct me. But I'm looking later in the fleet guides. So, looking at the backside. The destroyer. Slightly smaller than the cruisers. All four are really fine ships. A nice addition to, for every Drenzy player, and a real hot opponent for every Kurok Alliance player, I hope. And so this was the Everlast from the Green Horde, and I will say thank you for watching. See you later for another video, another unboxing or a bed wrap, maybe some board games or even another tabletop game. Let's surprise. I hope I will not get I don't know. I hope I will paint this one faster than my Ceruleans. And yeah, Christmas is a goal for me that these models are all painted. I hope I will get it. So feel free to leave comments, and we will see you by the next in the next videos. And thanks for watching, and good night. Bye.